Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to present my study here. HIFU therapy can cause the necrosis of lesions in soft tissue depending on the cauterization through high temperature at the focus spot. On the other hand, the sonication to the bone can cause the protein denaturation of sensitized nerve fibers depending on the increased temperature of the surface of the target bone. This process can be used for the management of pain of bone and joint disease. Actually, the pain relief effect of FUS has been reported, as shown on the slide. In this study, the target disease were bone metastasis, lumbar facet osteoarthritis, and medial component of knee osteoarthritis. We selected the patient who have tenderness at the lesion site, and sonication was conducted at the location of the most severe tenderness. The illustration shows the difference between subjective pain and tenderness. Subjective pain is the perception which patients are feeling. Tenderness is sensitive pain caused by a pressure. There are differences in the intensity of tenderness depending on the location of the pressure. The aim of this study is to enhance the effect of ultrasound therapy more effectively. First, to clarify the difference in pain relief effect among three diseases. Second, in order to decide and narrow down a target area, FUS was conducted at the location of most severe tenderness in patients who have tenderness at the lesion site. Third, for the quantitative analysis of the intensity of local pain, the change in the intensity of tenderness at the treated area was clarified. The number of patients, their gender, and age are shown on the slide. I will show you inclusion criteria. Patient's worst pain intensity was more than 4 points, and patients have a tenderness at the lesion site. Additional criteria of bone metastasis, patient did not candidate for radiation and refused other treatment. Their risk of pathological fracture were low. Primary cancer, target location, and targeted lesion type are shown on the slide. Lumbar facet OA, patient were age 65 or over, and had lower back pain lasting for more than 6 months and had no radiculopathy. We selected patients who obtained pain reduction of more than 17% by diagnostic broke, and target facet joint were limited to less than 2. Knee OA, patients were aged 60 or over, and they had knee pain associated with medial compartment of knee OA for more than 6 months, and could be applied with artificial joint replacement. The treatment was conducted using an exacerbate system. In bone metastasis, the site of most severe tenderness was irradiated. In lumbar facet OA, the backside of the joint was irradiated. In knee OA, the medial side of thigh bone and tibia bone associated with tenderness is irradiated. Preset temperature on the surface of bone for each disease was shown as the slide. As for outcome measure, the intensity of maximum subjective pain at the site of lesion was measured using NRS, and the ratio of responders were calculated. Responder was defined as 50% or greater decrease in NRS score 1 month after treatment, compared to the before treatment. Then, the threshold of pressure pain hereafter PPT was measured using a handheld algometer shown in the slide. Clinician compressed the target site at constant speed, and patient pushed the button when they felt the pressure as slight pain. At the same time, the compression intensity is recorded. We measured PPT at the treatment site and the opposite site of the same site as the control. Result. The NRS score significantly decreased from 1 week to 3 months after treatment compared with before treatment in all groups. In bone metastasis group, NRS score gradually decreased during 3 months, blue line, compared with other groups. It was suggested that long-term pain-reducing effect were not only caused by effect of protein degeneration or irritated nerve fiber, but also anti-tumor effect and bone formation. In all diseases, PPT in the site of lesion was significantly lower compared to those of the control, and the PPT in treated site was significantly higher from 1 week to 3 months after treatment compared to the before treatment. These results suggest that the patient was sensitive in painful areas with less pressure, and irritated nerve fibers at the lesion site was thermally denatured. The rate of responders in bone metastasis was higher than that of osteoarthritis. This is probably because the pain etiology was different between the two diseases. In bone metastasis, irritated nerve fiber due to fragile bone and inflammatory cytokine caused by cancer were probably main causes of the pain, while in osteoarthritis, not only sensitized nerve fiber, but also synovium, tendon, and mass other than the treated site were possibly included in the pain. The slide shows the comparison between responders and non-responders. NRS of responders significantly decreased and PPT significantly increased. It was suggested that for the evaluation of local pain, PPT is useful for quantitative evaluation and assessment of treatment effect after MRGFS. Conclusion is shown as the slide. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Namba. Nice results in extremely important and relevant field. I think that further research should be carried out in this field to go to a very, very relevant field in MSK with a huge impact on clinical practice. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.